Well, hey crafty friends, it's Hiedi Scott with DIY Dreaming, and oh my goodness, I am so excited about this project today. So, we are going to be making poppies out of coffee filters. We're going to be using Waverly, I think this is called brick. Crimson, red paint from Walmart. We're gonna be using the ink, Waverly brand from Walmart. And we're gonna be using this maize, light yellow from Walmart paint, okay? We'll be using a little hot glue. And then I'm gonna show you how you can make something really pretty on a black canvas, which you can get these at Walmart as well. So, you may have everything that you need if you're a coffee drinker and you have this style of a coffee pot. You may already have everything that you need to do this project. As you're hopping on Facebook, say hello, tell me where you're watching from, feel free to sprinkle, feel free to ask questions. If you're watching on YouTube, hit the subscribe button, feel free to ask questions, and let's just hop right in. Okay. So, I have done a lot of different flowers in my crafting time here on DIY Dreaming. This was one set that we made a long time ago. These are hydrangeas. This is really a more complicated flower, and I made them in the two kind of colors that they traditionally come. We also made a bunch of these that look like either shabby roses or peonies, or I don't know, they look like something. And this was really fun. And then, of course, you can see behind me, I've done all kinds of other flowers, from making flowers out of champagne corks and sheet music, to making flowers out of buttons, to making flowers out of burlap ribbon. I mean, I've done a ton of different flowers in the last 4 years here on this page. So if you want to look at any of that, just click. If you're watching on Facebook, just click the videos tab and you can scroll. If you're watching on YouTube, just click my, I have a bunch of different playlists, and I have one that's entitled DIY Flowers, and you'll see everything there. Okay, so the first thing you're going to do is you're going to take your coffee filters. And you definitely want to work in an area where your crafting surface is protected. And I just took some of this crimson red Waverly matte finish no prep acrylic paint from Plaid from Walmart, poured it into this little mason jar, and then I added a good bit of water. Okay, and then you may want to wear gloves. It's totally up to you. This is a very messy project. Okay, I'm working on the back of these Wilton cake boards from Walmart because they're great. And it's kind of nice if you're working somewhere where it's sunny, if you can take your board, I'll show you in just a second, outside and let it dry in the sun. So what I'm gonna do, these are a few things I've discovered in doing this project. At first I just folded a whole clump of coffee filters, like about 8 times, and I dipped that in. But then it was hard, I found, to get the little, the pieces separated. So now basically what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna fold it like a piece of pie, however many times you want, it really doesn't matter. I'll just show you one. And you are basically just going to dip it into your paint and water mixture, and you'll see the color of the paint will start to climb up it. Now this is one thing I want to say, there's all different varieties of poppies. Some are fully red, some have little bits of white on them. I do have some poppy facts to share also. Some are different colors altogether, but we're doing your traditional style. So you could choose to leave the center of your flower white if you would like, and then we can add to it. It's just up to you. So basically, you can see, I'll hold this up. How the red just creeps up on these coffee filters. And if you put them out in the sun, they take less than 20 minutes to dry, seriously. Unless, you know, it's a super duper humid climate where you are, it might take just a little bit longer. So I took this outside. And then the other thing I did was I took another coffee filter, the two other things that I did. Let's just do it right here. Okay, and I'm doing this variety of poppy flowers that has a little smidge of yellow in the center. So I had like two drops of this maize colored paint left, and I just filled it up with water. And then I just took a yucky paintbrush and I painted. You really only need one of these for a whole bunch of flowers, and I'll show you why. But I made three because I didn't know what to anticipate. And then I took that outside to dry. And then I did one more thing, which I won't show you. It's pretty easy to understand. I took another filter and I just painted it straight with the black ink. Paint. I did not dilute this, but you certainly could if you wanted. And then I took all of these outside on my little Wilson cake board and I set it out on a table in the sunshine, and they dry pretty quickly. Okay, so let's put this aside. Where can I put it so I don't bump it? Okay, so once you have your bits painted, let's talk about poppies for a second. Okay. And I had this whole, I looked at all these facts. You guys, I'm so technically challenged. And then I accidentally deleted it. So I'm just going from my memory of what I remembered looking up. Okay, so I want to know, when you think of poppies, do you think of poppy seed muffins? Do you think of that red color? Or do you have a tendency to think about opium and sedatives and stuff like that? So tell me in the comments what your initial thoughts are when you think of poppies. My initial thought is that red color. And then I thought of poppy seed muffins. And then I thought about all the medicinal kind of things that have been done with poppies over the years. So let me tell you a few facts. There are, and this is what we're aiming towards, and we can do all different variations of it. Okay, so I thought of, I looked it up, and there are apparently 120 different varieties of poppies. They're not all red. I did not know that. They come in yellow, orange, pink, lilac, like a violet color. And I also saw that there is one poppy, I believe it was called an Icelandic poppy, and it was a very light blue. So they come in a bunch of different colors, but this is kind of what I generally, or this is what comes to my mind when I think of poppies. They're mostly grown in the Northern Hemisphere, and if you are a plant person, they are either an annual, typically, or a very short-lived perennial. And, but they're not something that you can plant in your yard, I don't believe, and have them come back year after year after year. The other thing is, I don't know if you really want to have a ton of poppies in your yard, because they are, they can be toxic. In fact, if you eat certain varieties of poppies, they're poisonous. And certain varieties of poppies are also poisonous just to touch. I did not know that. So the poppy seeds that they use, that they make, you know, you can get those little containers of them for your baking needs, or for a strawberry poppy seed salad. Those are so yummy. Anyways, They come from two different varieties of poppies that are not toxic. Okay. And symbolism, they symbolize a whole bunch of different things. They were like a flower that was symbolic of lost soldiers in one of the wars, World War I or World War II. They're also the birth month flower of August, which is my birth month. So, and then they have a lot of other meanings, but they just make me happy. Okay, so I'm gonna show you how to make these. All right, so typically they have 4 to 6 petals, and we're not doing a totally accurate version of it. We're just doing, you know, our rendition. And like I used the paint to create the wash for the coffee filters, but there's lots of other mediums that you could use. So use what you have whenever possible. And this is what I had on hand, and it just happened to be the perfect color. So I did all of these this morning. I've been playing. Okay, so one of our followers, Judy, says that orange poppies are usually wild growing on the side of the highways or the fields in California. You know, I've seen those out west too. Okay, so some of my little coffee filters, when they were dry, I just took a little bit of that black paint and I painted it messy in the center. And I'm gonna stack up, I'm not gonna use all the ones that have the black in the center. I'm gonna stack up, this other one has 4 layers. Let's make 6 on this one that we're gonna do. So let's do another one. Let's got this. Some of these I could not get them apart, and I bet you they're 2 layers thick. So what do you guys think so far? Do you like this idea? You guys, this is, I don't know why I thought poppies would be hard to do. What was I thinking? I wasn't thinking. Because this is one of the more simple type of coffee filter flowers that you can make. Okay, let me just scroll ahead. You should have known I was an August baby. I'm a Leo. Can you tell that? I don't necessarily believe in all that astrology stuff, just FYI, but I know some people do. Okay, so I'm going to put the ones that have the little black, a couple of them at the beginning, and then one at the very base of it. All right, and what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to cut them different lengths. Okay, can you see how these are different? So they're different sizes. And where's my ruler? Buried in. Here it is. Okay. So a coffee filter is generally, the ones I have anyways, you can get these at Dollar Tree, you can get them at any grocery store. And I used the white. I don't know if you could use the natural or not, but you can try if you would like. They're generally not quite 8 inches. So I'm going to start with my center ones being about 5 inches. So that means I'm going to put 2 of them together and fold them into a pizza. They're just easier to cut that way. And I'll show you how I do this kind of little ruffle cut. So 5 divided by 2 is 2.5. And I'm just going to measure, you know, from the point out and then just kind of visualize where that is. And I'm taking some scissors. And I'm just doing this little, I don't know if this is accurate or not, but like I said, this is just a hint to poppies. It's not meant to completely be accurate. So here's what we have for our 2 top pieces. Oops. Okay. And then the next ones, the next 2, I'm going to do 3 and a fourth inches. I'm going to do about 3, a little bit over 3. I can always cut these smaller, but once you cut them, you can't cut them bigger, right? So can you see how I just did a tiny little messy scallop? Let's open this up and see if this is gonna work with the ones that we've cut already. Ooh, you know what? I think this one needs to be smaller is what it is. So let's cut this just a little bit smaller. There's no right or wrong. You could do them all the same if you want. Okay, let's see how this is gonna work. Yes, better. Okay, and then the last ones, I'm gonna leave them just like what they are. But I am gonna cut a teeny little scallop on them just to make them have a pretty ruffly looking edge. Wow, so there's lots of you guys on. Hey, if you like doing flowers, and mostly what I do here at DIY Dreaming, both on Facebook and on YouTube, is I do projects that involve faith. I do projects that involve family, and then I do a lot of projects that involve flowers. So if you like faith, family, or flowers, or have friends that like those things, I would love to have you come back again. I'd love to have you follow or subscribe, and it would be awesome if you would sprinkle, consider sprinkling, you don't necessarily have to your friends on social media. And I don't know how you sprinkle from YouTube. I'm not super great with technology. Okay, this last one, I put the black on the outside. So it's like we have a little layered, can you guys see that? And this one is 6, this one is 4. So we may decide that that is too many, I don't know. All right, I am just using my very basic low temperature hot glue gun, and I'm gluing my layers together in the center with just a little blob. Basically just stacking them up like a pizza. Or not like a pizza, I don't know what it's like. Okay. And here is the beginning of our poppy. All right, there's lots of different things that you could do. I'm preferring to create this sort of eyelashy looking thing that I notice in a lot of poppies that I believe their variety is called poppy cornflowers, because they have this like little eyelashy kind of thing happening. Not eyelashy, but I don't even know what these flower parts are called. But they have these little things sticking up, and then in the center, they have a little bit of yellow. And I think on this one, I made that little bit of yellow too big. But we'll experiment with that. So that's the style we're making. You could do it completely black. Or you could do it with a ring of white before the black. But I've seen those kind of flowers too. Okay, so what we're gonna wanna do is bring up all our layers one at a time and give them a good scrunch. And then we're going to fold them back out and we're going to build the inside. And I'm hoping that you guys can see okay. I think you probably can. If you're watching on Facebook, oh, thank you for all the hearts. If you like this, smash the hearts. If you're watching on Facebook and the comments are in your way, this is not a problem on YouTube, but if you are, then you should be able to swipe them either up or down, left or right, with either your finger, your cursor, your mouse, depending on what kind of device you're watching this on. And that will help. Okay, so I'm basically just folding out all my scrunched layers. I don't know, 6 might be good, or it might be overkill. 6 layers, I'm not sure. And that's pretty just like that, don't you think? Oh, Sarah says last night she created my paper hydrangeas. Let's get out of the container. We need to do these again. They're a little bit more complicated because you have to cut your coffee filters in this very specific shape to get the shape of a coffee filter, and we also made leaves when we did that. That was definitely a fun project. Go in there. So you could go just like this, but I want to show you what I did. Okay, so on that coffee filter that I just painted black, this is sort of like one of the kind of flowers that I like to make frequently that look like this. Do you guys remember when we made these? This is sort of this idea, sort of. So I'm gonna cut off a strip. I'll hold it up in just a second. That I folded in half. And actually it doesn't even have to be folded in half, I don't know. And then I'm gonna fold it a few more times just so I don't have to do so much cutting. And then we're just gonna take tiny snips to sort of create those, that fringy, eyelashy look and stuff. Okay, so here's what we've got. Let me open it up and show you. And you can make your poppies absolutely whatever size you want. So maybe you make this smaller, I don't know. But this is kind of what it looks like. And then I'm just gonna glue a little bit of it into the inside, not a ton. Snip it off right here in a circle. Oops, this is not my glue gun. That's my heat gun. Okay. I'll hold this up in just a second and show you what I'm doing. So I just sort of bent it and I'm wrapping it around the little black circle. And I missed a spot. And like I said, this is not absolutely necessary. It's completely optional what you want. Okay, and this is what that looks like. Strings like I do. I have a few here. You can take a heat gun or even a blow dryer and just go over the top of your project, and that seems to just melt them away. Okay, I forgot to mention this. One, there's two ways you can do this. You could use a big button, a big black button, and then a little yellow button in the center. I'll show you. Like, and that could be the center of your poppy. I probably will make one like that just so that you can see. And you can use, you know, any kind of larger black button. Like this one has an anchor on it, but I would just flip it over and use the reverse side. And then most of the pictures that I looked at of poppies have this kind of like light yellow center. Some also look a little bit light green, but I'm still seeing blue strings. Okay. So So this is what we have so far. So with the yellow that I painted, with that color called Maze, I'm just gonna tear off a little bit of it. And we're gonna totally crumple that up. And I'm going to tack that down with a little dot of glue in the center. Okay. So then I'm going to crumple it all up again. And this is the first one that has four layers, and this is the second one that has six. So you can see what you like better. If you like the thicker one, and it might be good to do a variety. Okay, so I was showing you these canvases. I got all of these at Walmart. You can get the stretch canvas ones that, what are these called? 8x12. This came in a 2-pack. It was not expensive. It's just your basic stretched canvas, but it's black. Then you can also get some that are just canvas panels. See, they're thin. Those came from Walmart also, and I have a bigger one that I was just going to fiddle around with just to see what that would look like. So if I was gonna glue these on here, I would do some smaller ones too, which we could do. Do you guys wanna do some smaller ones? And then we'll figure out after we do that what we want our, if we want leaves, I'm not sure about that. Or if we want, just gonna put a little on here, or if we want stems or that kind of thing. I do feel like this is too big. This center I've got right here. So let me just try to snip a little bit out of it. Tell me, either way, if you're on Facebook or YouTube or anywhere else that you stumble on this in the future, tell me what you think. Do you like this? Now, if you want it to be even like a darker red, you can achieve that. You just need a different color of paint. This is called Crimson, and this is what I had on hand, and I like this color. I like how when you paint your coffee filters, you get a variation of different kind of darknesses and lightness of shades. Charlene says she loves it, it's lovely. This is totally my jam. If this is your jam, making things out of like nothing, then you should definitely think about, you know, following me on Facebook or subscribing to my YouTube channel. Because this is the kind of stuff I like to do all the time. Okay, let's do one with just four, but let's make it quite a bit smaller and let's see how that looks. I'm just going to eyeball it. Make these quite a bit smaller. First layer. Second layer, we'll just hold that first layer up there to get an idea of how much bigger to go. because I do want this one to be smaller than the other two that we have. See, what I'm doing is I'm just holding one, the smaller one, on top of the bigger one. And I'm doing the same thing. I'm putting the dark color last, although I don't know if it really makes a difference or not. I might flip it around. This is like an experiment. Not totally. Because I have not done poppies before. Love the idea. Can you make one with buttons for the center? Yes, let's do this one with the buttons. Great idea. I don't know that I would put buttons combined with the other on the same, you know, piece of art, but I don't know. Let's see how it looks. Okay, so let's open. For this one, we just have four layers happening, except I think this one happens to be two layers thick. So let's glue. And I kind of like this look in the center. I have seen some poppies that have little bits of white poking out from the center. So I don't know. It's all in the eye of the crafter. Okay, nice. French it all up, and then we'll play with the buttons. And the buttons I have are all vintage-ish ones that lots of you guys have sent them to me. Thank you so much, because I love buttons. I love buttons. A lot of them I picked up at different, like, antique malls. And I did actually at one point order some beautiful creamy white and gray vintage mother of pearl buttons on, I think it was on Etsy, but they were kind of expensive. So, but you can get buttons all over. Okay, so here's what it's looking like. And, you know, and I don't know, maybe you don't want to scrunch it as much. It's just totally up to you. So we could use this button right here. But let's use the back of it. And let's add this. These are the cutest little buttons. These remind me of little teeny, teeny bundt cakes. So let me glue that on here. If you don't have this, you can do the other method. If you don't have, you know, yellow buttons, I have like 12. Yellow's not a very common color for me to collect in buttons. So here's our center. Look how cute that is. And let's just stick it in here and see how it looks. Okay, that is pretty cute. Could put this on the same project. I was going to do two smaller ones here and here. So, and then I need to figure out what the stems are. I need to study a little more about poppies and see what they're in nature, what their stems, and if I know they have leaves. One of the facts that I read when I was getting ready to come live, let's take another little one, was that some poppies can grow up to 3 feet tall. And those are kind of like those ones that grow, that are orange sometimes, that grow along the side of the road. I thought that was very interesting. Okay, See, I'm not even measuring, I'm just eyeballing. Who knew that they came in so many different colors? I have no idea. I'm looking for one that's darker. This is darker. Stems are wonky. Use pipe cleaners. You know what? That's kind of what I was thinking, but I have these awesome pipe cleaners. I can't remember what they're called, but they're wrapped with, I don't know, they're wrapped with something, and they're just really awesome looking. So I'll have to dig those out of my box of faux florals and see. What about leaves? What do you guys know about leaves? Do they typically have a certain kind of leaf? By the way, if you just hopped on late here, you can come back later. Oh, thank you so much for the stars. You guys are so kind. You can come back later. Wait, I'm missing one. Where did I go? Oh, here it is. You can come back later and watch this video on replay. Also, I would love it if you would sprinkle this video to whatever social media you like to use. Or just, I mean, tell your flower loving friends about it if you would like. I know I have flower loving friends. Do you guys? Sounds kind of weird. Okay, let's do buttons again. Ooh, but I don't have a real small one. Let me get my button case out. And let's see if I can find a smaller black one. Similar to that first one. And also I don't want it to be too thick because then it'll be really heavy. Okay, this works just perfect. Nothing special about that button. And let's do the same little bunt cake looking thing in the center. Oops. You could just use regular modern buttons too. It doesn't have to be vintage. Okay, so let's scrunch our layers. And then open them up. Different method for making poppy flowers. This is just my way, my easy, you know, way to make it happen with what I had on hand. But I would love to see pictures of what you have if you've made poppies, whether it's this way or any other way. So I do have a group that I set up. Gosh, I don't know, maybe 2 years ago, called Dreamy DIY, and it's a group that I created for us, all of us, to be able to share our pictures of our craft projects and get even more ideas. And I don't know if you're like me, but I'm married and I have two sons, and honestly, they're all fabulous. I also have a daughter-in-law. She's wonderful. But nobody really cares about my crafts. So if I run out into the other room from my craft room here and say, oh my gosh, look at these poppies. Aren't these the cutest things? They're gonna say, yeah, mom. They're just not gonna get it. So that's one of the reasons why I set that group up, because I think everybody needs to have a little affirmation, you know, that when you're crafting, and so you can get that in that group. You post pictures of what you're making, and the other people in the craft group genuinely are going to be saying, oh my gosh, that is beautiful. I love it. So if you're, you know, longing for some of that, or you just want to get as many ideas as possible, then I invite you to join that group. It's Dreamy DIY, and share your pictures there. And you don't have a lot of rules. The only thing is, please don't use that group as a place to solicit sales for makeup or, you know, craft supplies or anything else. And be nice. We'll figure out some stems and just later today. And don't share other crafters' videos there, please. Like Sweet Barb from Shabby Tree. She's awesome. I love her. I follow her. But please don't share her videos on my page, on my group that I created called Dreamy DIY, because then I get questions. How did you do this? Where did you get that? And I know a lot of times people do that, just not even thinking about it, but that's one thing that I definitely ask that you not do, is not share other crafters' videos there. Be nice. And don't solicit any kind of sales. So I don't know, what do you guys think? Do you like these centers with just this crunched yellow paper and these little like black eyelashy things that we made? Or do you like the ones that we made, with the buttons? And I think this is adorable. I would definitely set it out. I could totally see displaying it. I mean, I could see that there might be some more things that we could do to it. How did you paint to get the color? That is all at the very beginning of the video. I showed the whole process, talked about how to dry it, everything, gave all the colors. So these were the colors of paint. And when I'm all finished here, feel free to go back and to watch the whole thing from the very start. These are all three Waverly acrylic paints from Walmart Craft Department. Let me see what other questions you guys have. Charlene says she likes both. Thank you. I kind of do too. I don't know. I think this one with the six layers is my favorite. And with the little eyelashy thing and the smaller crumpled piece of yellow paper. So this one has six layers. This has four, four, and four. And then they're all different sizes. You like the ones without the buttons, Patricia says. Yeah, I mean, it's all personal preference. So here's one thing for me to tell you. When I do crafts here at DIY Dreaming, I am not trying to do the most awesome in the whole world poppy flowers made out of coffee filters. Really, what my attitude or motivation is to show you some steps and give you some ideas and inspire you to do it your way, in your colors, you know, according to what makes your heart go pitter-pat. So take the ideas that you like and leave the rest. I just wanted to make sure that I showed you two different ways to do the center today, and that's why we did. Okay, just read a fun comment from, Nona, who says that her husband is interested in her crafting and he cuts wood shapes for you. Well, you guys, my husband is awesome. He really is. And my kids are awesome too. But they're just, it's not their thing like it is mine. I have a craft brain 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Yeah. Let's see. Do we have any other questions? Whoops. I'm so sorry that I sent my phone shaking when I was trying to scroll. Yes, you can use acrylics. You could use watercolor. You could use markers, like this. Let's cut them out. Like this, and then you spray water on it, and it will kind of tend to bleed. But what I opted to do was just to dilute some red acrylic paint, because that's what I had on hand. And I just think you should make crafts with what you have on hand whenever possible. Oh, thank you. Somebody said I'm good at flower making. I love flowers. Oh, I could make some sort of flower pot. Ooh, that's an adorable idea. I will start thinking on that, because I could use some of those cork sheets that you get from Dollar Tree. If I had known I was going to do that, I might have put things up a little higher on here. But you know those cork sheets that you can get at Dollar Tree that are thin and they have adhesive on the back? You could use those to mimic terracotta pots. It would be cute in a basket, yeah. I just wanted to do it on a piece of art instead of like these. These were sunflowers that we made a while ago. Look how cute those are. And I put them on skewers. These were the cherry blossom flowers that we made. And I just used actual sticks from my yard for that. These were some flowers that we made just not too long ago, a few weeks ago, week and a half ago, something like that, using some vintage quilts that my friend Anne sent me that were all, they were all cut up, torn up. So I didn't take a beautiful vintage quilt and cut it into pieces. So you don't need to scold me for using bits and pieces of a very torn and tattered, beautiful quilt. So I'm just looking, what else do I have here? These were some fun flowers that I did last year. These ones I called, what did I call these? Oh, I called these lollipop flowers. Because don't they kind of remind you of that? With the little swirly thing in the center. And this is just burlap. This is burlap that had these little polka dots on it that I picked up at Walmart. And then these were some flowers that I made a whole bunch of these last year, around 4th of July-ish. And these have little bits of lace, vintage buttons. This is quilt batting. This is canvas duck. This is ticking. Ticking, I made this fabric right here using the Victorian pattern stencil from magnoliadiy.com, which I love to do, and some lace. And I just put these on these little dowels. And at the same time, we need to do this again. These, I called these twirly-doos. And they're just a piece of red. They look super cute in the arrangement with this. Cut like the little, sort of like the eyelash thing, but cut over the fold. And then you wind them and glue them onto your wire. So. Yep, lots and lots of different flowers here. And if you want to look at any of those, you're here on Facebook. You can just click the videos tab and start scrolling. I try my very best to have every video labeled with a picture that shows what I'm making it. So you can go back 4 years and watch videos of different things that I've made, and you can know exactly what you're going to be getting from the label and the photo for each video. And then the same thing on YouTube, and just click the DIY flowers playlist, and there's, I don't know, 50 videos there maybe. I do seriously love flowers. So they could sort of look like pussy willows. Yeah, I kind of agree. You want to learn how to make the twirly doos. Let's do that. We'll do twirly doos next week. And also, I'm going to share some pictures of different sunflowers, that sunflower flowers that I've made, and different sunflower projects that I've made over the last 4 years. I'm going to share that either later today or tomorrow morning. Just to honor Ukraine, because I don't know if you knew this, but their national flower is the sunflower, and I do have some projects that I'm working on as well. We're going to be using, is it right here? Yes, it is. We're going to be doing some watercolor projects using this stencil from magnoliadiy.com. Okay, I've used it a lot and it looks terrible, so it's hard to even see what it is, but it still works perfectly fine. It's half of a sunflower, and then it says, in a field of roses, she is a sunflower. So we won't be doing that part, but we'll be using this amazing sunflower. I have another stencil that has a sunflower on it too. So we'll be doing some things just to, just to think, and can get all weepy just thinking about what's going on in the world. But anyways, I want to do some sunflower projects with blue and yellow, because those are the colors that Ukraine has on their flag, just to say we're thinking about you. And I think personally that I will, from now on, every time I see a sunflower, I'm gonna think about that country. So okay, well, I'm gonna let you guys go. But thank you so much for joining me. If you enjoyed this, please consider sprinkling it to your social media. If you joined us late, please feel free to go back and watch it from the very beginning, either here on Facebook or here on YouTube. And yeah, I will see you guys later today. Thanks for watching. Bye. Oh my gosh, I hate to ever hang up when there's a bunch of these coming up, but I'm going to, because I have talked on and on long enough.